Hello and welcome! In this video we are going to take a look at the new smartlink element in Consteel 14. So what is this new link element? The smartlink is a special version of the already existing link element that is designed to provide an easy to use and automatically updated connection between beam elements. Comparing the two, the normal link element is defined by two points, its start and end locations. In case of the smartlink, only the starting point has to be known, so it can be defined by only one point. The position of the endpoint is calculated based on what kind of beam the link is connected to and the settings of the link. On the dialog at the main section part, you can set that at which point you want the link to connect to within the specific section of the beam you put the link on. For example, you can just define one with top middle or bottom right eccentricity. Additionally, you can manually add the eccentricities within the plane of the section. So if you want to connect something to a point 100 mm above the section, it can be done like this. The square-shaped symbol on the link shows the position of the release. Automatically it is placed onto the perimeter of the section, but you can also position it manually. Another optional setting is the connecting section, where instead of or additionally to a manual eccentricity input, you can set what kind of section and also which part of it you want to connect to the main section. So let's say I want to connect the bottom middle part of a Z200 cold formed section to the top middle part of these beams. With these two links I can easily define the Z200 section, positioned perfectly on top of the other two beams. This type of link element behaves as if it was attached to its main section, which means it automatically gets adjusted to follow any changes made on that element. For example, I can change the section, and the link will follow that change. It reacts the same way if I move the element. Or if I change the rotation of it. Generally, the smartlink is designed to handle situations where there is a hierarchy between the beams that it connects, in a situation where there is some kind of a primary structure already in the model and secondary structural elements are to be connected to it, the smartlink provides an easy to use and automatically updated modeling tool to handle those connections. Now that we covered the basics, let's see a couple usage examples of this connection element. In this first example, we have a simple model of a floor slab supported by primary and secondary beams. The beams are connected by links, which are set up in a way that the top of the beams are at the same height. This way, it is ensured that no matter how I change the section of the primary beams during the design phase, the top of the beams will remain leveled. In this next example, I intend to include the roof purlins into the model of this warehouse building. The purlins can be easily defined with the help of the smart link. Let's fast forward to a point where I defined all the purlins with this method. Now if I change the section of the rafters, the purlin's position will follow that change. Also, if I change the section of the purlins, the connections can be properly set by changing the subsection setting on all the link elements. Since the link follows any changes made to its main section, certain modifications on a model can be automatically made by clever application of the link. For example, let's say I would like to add bracing against lateral torsional buckling to these rafters, so I might be able to use a smaller beam section. The insertion points of the bracing can be defined by the smart link. I know the bracing will always connect to the bottom flange of the rafter, and I also know all bracings will connect to the purlins 1 meter away from the purlin support. Having the links properly defined, I can easily insert the bracing member into its place. From this point, I can make any modification to the rafters or its hunches, and the bracing will follow accordingly. Let's switch to a model version where all of the flange bracings are already added and check the utilization of the rafters with these changes. Based on the results, the beam section size and the hunch height can probably be reduced. Let's jump ahead to the member utilizations once again. With these modifications, the rafters are optimized for having additional flange bracings. By using smart links for this task, I was able to avoid additional modeling work during the design of my structure. This concludes our introduction of the smart link element in Consteel 14. We hope you found this video useful. If you did, please consider liking and subscribing. Also visit consteelsoftware.com and download a trial version of Consteel for free if you're interested. Thank you for your attention. Bye!